Was there, the president is there. Zarif got up and walked out and went somewhere in emergency because he knew what I was going to say. I mean, we that close. He knew what I was going to say. No, we ain't putting up. I said, these people here is the ones, you know, the people downtown, let's call them the Daftaris, they invite and they hug and kiss. They do the same program that's in line with the American program. We're not putting up with it. We can't put up with it. It's not our job to put up with it. It's our job to this go around. Just to put up, we say we got to do a $15 million deal, $150 million, $150 billion. We have to rise to the occasion of our time. Now, think about it. It may not seem like it, but every historical period, we've risen to the occasion of our time. And we ain't had no help from nobody, hardly. And we, like inside of America, we all see it. Everybody, how can everybody be against it? I mean, just it ain't everybody is not against Jamaat Tabligh. Somebody said, man, y'all not good. Right? Some people don't like Islam. Some people like Islam. Some people don't like Aluma, Imam Jamil's community. Some like them. But how is it that everybody, you go ask anybody, and they'll say, they do this over by Jidal Islam, they do that, the Iranians buy everything for them. And I says, is that right? You know, just think about it. All the mean stuff we supposed to do, not only people don't help us, except maybe not now Ramadan now, a few people help, and a few people, we let a few people help us with. One brother's wanted to do, they wanted to do the food every night. We said, no, we got to do some of it because we, you know, we got to do just what we do. But where can you go? If you think I'm jiving, go over there to another masjid and let one of them pioneers give you a free meal. See if you get a free meal. And the seniors' meal that they have during the day, they get that from, what's the place right out here? The Negroes, right out here.
Sweet Tooth.
Sweet Tooth. And over there, they get the money from the government to pay Sweet Tooth. We don't get no government money. We wouldn't even accept no government money.
I just want to mention real quick, like, some people over at Sweet Tooth, that's kind of imam-like, had a problem with, you know how you got licenses and all that stuff? And we kind of know how the people dress, you know, kind of kifaya-like and so. But when it came time to go down there and see that judge, suit.
Oh, yeah.
Suit and all that other get-up was kicked to the side.
Hey, man. We're a miracle crew that we'd have survived all of these years, all of this time, and with no real help. And in the last years, we go so far as to say, the closer you get to now, the less help we would get. But that don't stop us. If we have food, tell you, man, I don't have no money. That's not gonna make us just get on in line. Ramadan, the same thing. Don't nobody provide no home-cooked meal every night. The Saudis will give you that slop. They used to give out that rice and meat mixed together that everybody eat with their hand. I don't know what they do now. But you don't get no veggies, meat or fish, salad. fruit, choice of fruits. Anything, watermelon, they don't do that, right? And that the box will have at least $7 to $8 per night in it. And anybody can count. If you were at a restaurant, they would charge you about $15 for those meals.
20 to 25.
Something like that. Plus, remember, it's not just the food. But you know the way you say you like the gravy?
Yeah.
Why is the gravy? You can see it's all kind of veggies blended up there. It might be celery. The gravy is a meal. If you eat rice and the gravy, you don't have to eat nothing else.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And if you eat the other kind of rice, it's got broccoli in it, it's got mixed vegetables, it's got, you know, and then if you have to bring the taste out with butter, you know, the accessories that go in the food cost more than the food that they serve. You know, I mean, the flavors, the spices, you know what I mean? They put one little pinch, a teaspoon of flavor in there, that's it. You know what I mean?
Can I say one thing?
Sure.
When you talking about everybody being against us, it's because of the truth. See, everything you presented has been the truth.
Right.
If anybody thinks to you that it's not true, they can always challenge you to prove it. But everything you said and done is the truth. And that's where the threat comes from, the truth. The truth. That's what they have a problem with, the truth.
It's the truth, and then we're independent. Mm-hmm. And this is not new. I mean, it was in Oakland in 83, and here comes a crew come from Baitul Din. Guy's name is Ali Abdul Malik. They bring a whole crew of phony shias to Oakland. Whole crew, a package crew. They're supposed to be there and divide us from, see, Berkeley, San Francisco, and that area was one of the main centers for the brothers and sisters. And they're going to come. Anyway, this is nothing new. It didn't work then, it's not gonna work now. But some of the last things we wanna say is, during this period, we've been the target of Saudi Arabia, specifically, for 37 years. Remember, as we said, their goal is like Saudi Arabia without Islam, China without communism, Iran without Islam. That's what the Muawiyah Janis people want to do. Iran, just like during the Shah's time, big military power, big wealthy country, but no Islam. That's why I tell the people you have three elements. You have two elements, but you have three realities. One, Allah that protected the Islamic Republic. Number two, the system of Velayati Faqih. And number three is the people of Iran themselves. That's what's protected it. And okay, our friends, the diplomats, they don't like Velayati Faqih. They don't want it. They want diplomacy. I tell them, Pakistan got diplomacy, look at it. Afghanistan got diplomacy, look at it. So everybody else got diplomacy. You want to get rid of what you have, Velayati Faqih, the just ruler in Islam. It's not like a ruler, not the dominating type of ruler, but a Hadi, a guide. That's why the new Shia community don't like us for the last 20 years because their main mistake is this. Their clique, their crew, their order. Like before, like say Iqbalis, if they have a revolution, any place that have a revolution, they have a party, and this country is ZANU, ZAPU, all those parties. When that party comes to power, they only trust people that was in the party. And they almost exclude all the other engineers, technicians that could help them run the country. They don't give them a position because they put a guy in there that was with them and don't know what he's doing because of party. In this stage, for us, we have to do exactly, and we try to stick to what we say. The Quran, Hadith, history, and our experience. Our experience tell us that this is not the period for party. I do things because of the party first. When we go to all these other meetings, each one of them do things because of the party first. They've all agreed on the party line. You notice that? That's why they don't want to hear nothing else. And if you got any other ideas, you can't participate in this. We don't want to hear it because analysis by design, designed outcome. We want everything to feed towards voting, to integration. So all that other stuff, oh, we know where you're coming from. I gave behind a wife one of the old 10 years old strategic management under conditions of oppression. As we was talking, he was reading in detail too. When he finished, he just looked at me and said, your skin is thicker than mine. In other words, that stuff is right. But I ain't into that.
I ain't gonna do it.
I ain't into that. I ain't into it. And they prove it. I move toward a close. Can you imagine how hilarious it is? Think about it. Well, it's the fourth or fifth time we've been down to care. They won't even come outside to say, hey man, I just didn't hear the phone, nothing. Can you imagine that they actually stay up there and listen to that all the time and won't even come to the window? White folks walk out, remember the first time? White folks walked out the door and they stopped, took pictures and listened. Time before last, the last time, how many Suburbans came by there and stopped and just and put their microphone out the window? They just playing, right? Time before that is the police. Remember the police and the councilman. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine how everybody just stopped by and to see us? How many Suburbans been by your house? Or how many police and council supporters and the Negro League and all that, right? This is insanity. No, look at how far they will go. We know we're on the right road, but we wouldn't get that much attention. All around the world.
So this
is our mission. We have to make sure that, and I will close with this, I'll try to. They got Nihad, they got Isna, Ikna, they got the, and they don't hide what they're doing. What's their theme? Last year, how can we integrate into America without losing some of the
assimilation? Assimilating to America without using, without losing your song?
We have never seen, you know, America brags. Sociological studies, this is 40 years ago or more. No people have ever came to America and kept their language, their culture over three generations. It just haven't happened. Look at the Italians in the 20s. They all spoke Italian. The second generation during the 40s and the 50s, right? they ate Italian food, they might have knew three or four words of Italian. But if they went back to Italy, they wouldn't know what the people was talking about, right? What about Italians now? You know any about Italians that speak Italian? They know what spaghetti is, they know the food. They know the food, but they don't know nothing else about Italy. What part of Italy? I don't know, somewhere down there. Just like the Negroes from the South. When we came from the South, we knew all about the South. Ask some Negro now, about 18 years old, or from Chicago. What about Mississippi? What part of Mississippi are you? I don't know about no niggas from Mississippi. But when the Impressions and all them was from Mississippi, everybody knew. So America has thrived on cutting down wherever you came from and making you what they want, and they'll send you back to blow away the people wherever you came from. They got dumb Muslims going to shoot Iraqis, right? Mm-hmm. They had dumb Germans going back to kill Germans. And they have dumb Italians going back to kill Italians. They cousin, they shoot his cousin down the street, right? That's what they're doing. They're trying to do that with Iranians. They're trying to do that with the Muslims. We ain't going for it. You can do it, boy, but we're going to talk about you all the way. You know what you're doing, boy? Huh? You know who that is? That's what our job is. And back to dreaming, back to the vision, we're doing what we want to do. It may look miserable to other people, but it ain't miserable to us. It's what, if Allah hook you up to allow you to do what you believe in, what you study, and what you think about, it's a blessing. So that's what the last point is, all these Muslims, they got set up to become popular. This old woman didn't get arrested every other day, that wear hijab. Those is hustlers. That's the app, I'm gonna call her Aileen Sharpton or something, right? Right? That's what she is, talking gangster talk. I'm proud to wear this. I said, you ain't been, I ain't seen you nowhere, but riding in some Cadillac or BMW to the demonstration and try to get the handcuffs over all them rings and diamonds and stuff, you know what I mean?
Don't leave out the lipstick.
Right, oh yeah.
Bright red.
They have it set up right now to usher in.
That's right.
That whole crew. That's what Nihad was telling me out there. He didn't know I knew what he was saying. No, there's something that works. I said, I can figure it out right away. I said, You and your homeboy, what's the Muslim?
Keith Ellison.
I said, yeah, I was all kind of suspicious, you know what I mean? I said, yeah, we'll see in 2-3 weeks what they done gave y'all. And remember, in the newspaper, what's that thing down there? Cooperating with Zionists. Saudi Arabia openly cooperating with Zionists. And the Iranians is a bad guy. But they can do anything they want. In closing, that's what we are. The Americans, the Saudis can do anything they want to us or say anything they want. It's okay. It's just okay. Because it's us. And they home folks can do whatever they want. Okay. We're going to try to do what we can. And the last thing. We didn't get here with your help. We love everybody. We're not arrogant. But when you got here, we was already here messing with the white man. Y'all didn't help us. For an Iranian organization to think that, oh, we turn against you and that'll break your spirit, Hell, are we hanging up with the cracker all of these years?
400.
Yeah. 400 and some years for everybody, and I got 50 years of direct contact with the cracker. Direct fitna. And still here, alive, happy, jumping up and down, turning flips right now. So you from Iran, what the hell, I mean, what do you think you gonna do? You gonna make me sad if we don't talk to you. We ain't gonna invite you to nowhere, no more anniversary of the revolution in February, no more the big Palestinian talks. What, you know what them fools forget? We was already here. We was already here. We already do what we've been doing all along, and we're still doing it now. This is what you gotta understand. You ain't gonna run nothing here. In fact, you keep messing around, we're gonna run your behind out of town. Yes, we are. If the white man can't do nothing to us but cause a little trouble, a little eye itch or something. You know, for a revolution, how much you know who gets eye itches? Doggone babies get the little kids get the, what if the little kids get pink eye? Oh, what the hell do they think I care about some damn pink eye? And that's supposed to make you mad. I don't know what it, I really don't. I don't think about it, except I look in the mirror, I said, my eyes is a little pink. I done had 3 or 4 things of medicine. I go there, they tell me, oh, you try something else. I said, I know what the damn medicine I take, and I take it for 2-3 days, and the damn thing is gone. If it lasts for 2 weeks or a month, because y'all engaged, part of the medicine is
making it worse.
Yeah. Now what it feel like, I get redder and redder and all. The point is, if that's what they gonna do, what? Other revolutionary, they drag them down the street, they boil them in oil, and all you gonna do is give a nigga pink eye. They ought to be, that is the sissifiers. Sweetie, I had to thank them for that. That's wonderful. Oh, you gonna straighten up, nigga, we gonna give you the pink eye. Right? That's what it adds up to. So we want everybody that's here to understand. We're right in the middle of this global issue. We've explained it to them from Lebanon, from Bashir. We've explained it to them from the regional vision. We've explained it to them that everything that they didn't want is exactly what they got. They didn't want Arab and Middle Eastern armies trained. But because of their fitna, they have the Syrian army trained. Of course, they don't leave people behind to cause trouble, it's okay. The Iraqi army trained, getting rid of Daesh. Daesh gonna be there to cause trouble. The Iranian army, big and ready to roll. This is exactly what they didn't want, and this is exactly what they have. Okay, same thing with us. They make examples out of all the niggas. You get out of line with us, we're gonna take your money, we're gonna take your job. Well, the job they take from me is fine. I had a job in 1966, they can have that boy. The people ask me at some office, some official office. Well, Mr. So-and-so, what is the last job you've had? I said, I had a job in 1966. He said, 1966? I said, yes, I had a job in 1966. I worked from 1965 to 1966. We can't be asked, you ask me when I don't care what you got, Social Security, disability. You can stick that up your behind. I told the people over there about a big chair. I said, hold it, homeboy, what are you talking about? Well, if you're don't get this and that. We don't. I said, you can stick your Social Security or disability up somebody's behind. You must be crazy. I got up and I said, you can't talk to me. I'm not dealing with no welfare. Same thing I tell the Iranians. If the white man himself can't get with us, and he got everything, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Well, we're gonna be mad. We're gonna take you off the list, the welcome list. Well, F you and your behind, man. You keep your list. You must be crazy. And I close with this for real. No, we got a big deal. This, tell the truth, that news is real. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump, the damn fool, is real. The bombings and killings of Muslims around the world is real. The Muslims being organized to take advantage of all their gifts is real. They're not taking advantage, they are losing advantage. Every advantage we have, Saudi Arabia is stepping in the way and causing trouble and problems for Islam and for Muslims. Okay, we have to do something about that, that's all. And I close. But we only need $15 million for this recent period, maybe the next couple of years. So any of y'all that got a couple hundred thousand, catch up with you, see that, $200,000. We only need $15 million. Now, you're going to be laughing or crying when we pop up with the money, because you don't think you're going to get it, do you? Well, this is the last closure. It's really a true closure. Everything we have announced since 1980, everything we've announced since 1980, we came up with. Everything. So, thank you very much. By the way, this is our supporter here. This is our main supporter. He is supporting our program by keeping you woke. See, without him, you'd be just with.
See what he's doing. He's crying because he's waiting on the 15 million.
The 15
million. He's over there crying like a baby.
You got to require them down. That's right. This is like public radio. If you want to stop all us talking, if you want to stop that noise, then you got to send us $15 million before the next
airing.
10 minutes. Yeah. So thank y'all very much. Assalamu alaikum.